Wonderful.
Where are you going?
What's your hair lately?
One drink all I had.
Grand dining tonight. Grand
so,
in the evening.
We start in G major and...
I told you, he's a sad, melancholy. Needs a minor key.
But I wanted to.
To ruin everything. We'll start in E.
Oh well. See, the crew's been hard at work. Not bad.
No. No, not all. But I'd imagine something more, you know, more theatrical.
Don't you like it? But I thought a boudoir would be right in line with your tastes.
Oh, you chose it. Well, I'm not saying it's bad. Just different. Not exactly what I'd envisaged. You know, now that I think about it, you're absolutely right. A boudoir is the perfect setting for a cabaret. What about Rotlick? Did you get the placards?
Rotlick said he'd bring them on his own. Should be here soon.
Great! The best way I can think of to promote the chameleon.
Never mentioned wanting to change the name.
Rosemary and Thyme wasn't all bad. But it conjured images of Temerian cuisine served by waitresses in peasant garb. Chameleon's a lot better for a cabaret, apart from which it emphasizes that the place has undergone a transformation. Just a better ring to it all round.
What about choreography? Prepared anything special for the opening?
We haven't. But Polly has. She's priceless. Came in and brought the girls in line before I could say knickers. Premier will have the audience on their feet, on their knees, both at the same time.
Guess everything's ready. So when's the opening?
Soon. We start our dress rehearsal in an hour. I just need to nip back home for my dress.
Thanks for everything.
Don't mention it.
Seems my cabaret dreams are about to come true. So, around to celebrate? I'm buying.
Why not?
That's my boy. The foreman mentioned he saw you and Priscilla talking.
He saw right.
And she say anything about me?
Said something that made me think she's not entirely normal.
What?
That you're responsible, got your feet planted firmly on the ground.
You're pulling my leg.
Not this time. One thing's eating me. How do you manage to get the loan from Sophronia?
Wasn't easy. She got so excited about our performance, I had to read to her for 4 hours. 4 hours from The Cloak and the Dagger.
You mean you didn't?
Are you crazy? Who do you think I am? She's late, of course. She knew how important this night was to me.
Of course she did. Probably just making herself gorgeous. Takes time, you know.
So it's true. A woman's vanity knows no bounds.
Master Dandelion! Priscilla! She's...
What? Speak, man!
She's badly, been attacked. They took her to Vormerius Hospital.
Attacked? She's hurt? Geralt, come with me, please.
Of course, let's go.
gods. Priscilla. Is she gonna live?
Well, I'd say that's certain. Her condition's critical but stable. Beg your pardon, but you are a relative?
Relative? No, a friend. A very close friend.
Dandelion, correct? She uttered the name in her few moments of lucidity. I am Joachim von Gratz, head of surgery. Until recently, a lecturer at Oxenfurt Academy.
Enough of the courtesies. What are her injuries, besides her eye?
A concussion, cranial swelling, incision into her larynx, and scalding inside the throat and esophagus. Clearly someone forced her to imbibe a caustic fluid.
So this was no ordinary attack, no robbery.
Clearly not. It was the act of a demented mind, and not its first.
How can you know that?
I've seen wounds like this. They're not the kind one would forget, don't you agree? In fact, just this week, a corpse turned up in the morgue with similar injuries. And no heart.
No heart? You mean that might have happened to Priscilla? Is someone looking into this?
This is Novigrad. Only the innocent burn here.
Geralt, I know I owe you 100 times over, but I need to ask you another favor. Find the bastard who did this. Find him. And kill him.
Don't need any convincing. Come on, Dandelion. Let's think about what we can do.
I would suggest examining the previous victim's corpse. It has yet to be autopsied. Doing so could very well provide some clues. No need to look astonished, gentlemen. As a surgeon, I know the importance of preventive medicine. Rather than wait for this maniac to strike again, I'd prefer to excise him. Not unlike a tumor.
Great analogy, but this tumor's not gonna sit there, wait to be excised. Appreciate the help, but I doubt you know what you're getting yourself into.
I know perfectly well. And I assure you, I can take care of myself.
Easy assurance to make, harder to back up. Especially if you've spent your whole life wielding a scalpel, not a sword.
Look at this scar. Don't be shy. Any idea what leaves such a mark?
A flail. Morningstar, maybe.
What do you think? A blow sustained at the operating table? No? Let me repeat, I know what I'm doing, and I wish to help.
Think they'll let me into the morgue?
By the main entrance, certainly not. But you can also get inside through the sewers.
The sewers? Travel them often, Doctor?
As often as required for, the pursuit of preventive medicine.
Alternative treatments. Aggressive ones, I'm guessing. Interesting.
We can discuss this en route. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm. Ready and intrigued. I'll get whoever did this, Dandelion. Even if it's Hierarch Hemelfart himself.
Thanks.
You lead.
So, preventive medicine you practice in the sewers. What's that about?
Sewing up drowner victims can grow awfully tedious. Is it not better to nip the problem in the bud? I tried to get the temple guard to enter the sewers, alas, to no avail. So I took matters into my own hands.
No charge.
Hear that?
Been hearing it for a while. Draw your weapon.
Excellent fool!
Thank you.
Priscilla. How's it look? Give it to me straight, no sugarcoating.
Her wounds will heal, but it's her voice that concerns me. Surely you understand what a terrible blow that would be to a Trobriand. Enough to strip her of the will to live.
Any remedy for that?
I fear only your friend Dandelion can be of help on that count. Take the ladder. This is the place. Come, the quicker we take care of this, the better.
Why? Got somewhere to be?
Someone might disturb us. The coroner, for example. Or Reverend Nathaniel Pastodi. Very well. We seek the corpse of a dwarven woodcarver.
Human. Wrong body type. Let's keep looking. Calluses on the fingers, sawdust in the beard, clothes sticky with sap. Must be our dwarf.
Excellent. I trust you don't grow weak in the knees at the sight of blood?
Not a bit. Start the autopsy.
Where?
See anything interesting on his legs?
His right foot. The ankle swollen, toenails broken. He clearly kicked something very hard right before he kicked the bucket.
Doesn't strike me as the right time for jokes.
Apologies. We surgeons, we've a different sensibility.
Mm-hmm. And a different sense of humor. Look at his hands. These welts. Rope burns, right? He was tied up.
I'd expect so. No one could sit through such torture unless bound.
Speaking from experience?
Yes, that of a victim. Spent a year in the dungeons of Tretagor. Long story.
Some other time, maybe. See the callus? Our dwarf wore a ring, but someone took it off him. Let's examine his torso.
What have we here? Deep wound on the left side of his rib cage, and a scar the length of his stomach.
Look at the scar. Wounds long and thin, an incision, but the edges are ragged.
Means nothing. Look, no swelling, no bruises. An old injury, perhaps an accident in the workplace.
Let's examine the chest wound. Yeah, heart carved out, wound cauterized.
Wait a minute, there's something else.
An egg from an amphibian. A salamander? Scorched but intact.
I attended some lectures in herpetology as a student. Afraid I don't recall any amphibians that would lay eggs in corpses. So either Professor Cochrane was deeply mistaken, or this is our murderer's doing.
Let's look at his head. Hair smells like it's burnt, like he was in a fire.
Notice anything else? That his eyes have been scooped out, for instance?
Let's examine the mouth. Burns, blisters.
Just like Priscilla's.
Those burn marks I see in his eye sockets.
Yes. And some gray dust. Ash, it seems. Very fine.
Murderer gouged out his eyes, then put burning coals in the sockets.
So it seems. Looking at the wounds, it appears our woodcarver was still alive when it happened.
All right. Think I know enough.
Enlighten me, please, because I've still no notion what this is about, what the motive might have been.
Sure of one thing, this was punishment.
Even the witch hunters don't engage in this kind of torture. What sin could possibly merit it?
Only the murderer knows that, and it's the key to finding him, or her. It's a lead worth following. Any idea what his name was?
Fabian Meyer. And I'm Hubert Reich, the coroner. I've come to perform the autopsy, but I see you've done it for me, Joachim. As always, you interfere where you're neither needed nor wanted, drag others into trouble in the process. Who is this?
A student. Lifelong learner. Got a couple questions for you.
Very well, speak. But be quick. Reverend Nathaniel has come by for an inspection. He'll be here shortly.
You old friends?
Hubert taught me the rudiments of medicine, long ago.
And not very well. You've still not mastered certain basic principles. For example, that a doctor's role is to treat the ill, not save the world.
You've not changed a bit.
A compliment?
No, a statement of fact. 30 years, and you've not changed a bit.
Woodcarver's body. Where was it found? It's important.
Plan to investigate? Exciting. He died in his workshop south of the market square, just beside the gate to Far Corners. That poor Trebirats was attacked there. City's abuzz about it. But the woodcarver, Eustace, the corpse collector, brought us the body. You should speak to him. Saw him just around the corner near... Oh, greetings, Your Reverence.
Who are these people? I believe I made it clear no one's to be allowed in under any circumstances.
You did, but they're friends of the deceased, here to collect the body.
Out of the question. Show them out at once.
As Your Reverence wishes. Gentlemen, follow me. You shall leave via another route.
Why do you cover for us?
I was covering my own arse. If Reverend Nathaniel had learned someone had entered the morgue, then cut open a corpse without his permission, I'd be in deep trouble. But you didn't give that a thought, did you, Joachim? As ever. Well, while I don't approve of your willfulness, I also wish to see this murderer hang. So, should I learn anything new related to this case, I will let you know.
Thank you.
Might have told me you know the coroner. We could have skipped the trip through the sewers.
I know him, thus I avoid him. I've said enough on the subject.
Don't aim to press you.
Thank you. I've nothing to hide. It's just an old wound, unhealed as yet. What will you do now?
Plenty of leads. Woodcarver's workshop, the corpse collector who found him, alley where Priscilla was attacked. Got work to do.
As do I. At the hospital. I must return there. But I shall keep my fingers crossed.
And I'll keep my eye on you.
Greetings!
Show me your wares. So long.
Need something sharpened? Reforged?
What do you have on offer? So long.
Eternal fire, why me?
My order is high.
I'd buy tomorrow what you can buy today.
Another drift.
On the road, now.
Sick of it all.
Cram it, arsewipe.
You were sweat like a sweater in that jacket.
You know who I am. I'm Jean-Baptiste the Third. Yes, those.
Who are you, what?
Hey, handsome.
Too, up your ass, Deviant! Whores can fight back!
Calm down, I'm not gonna hurt you. What are you doing here?
Getting vengeance. Well, why are you staring? Have you not heard killers always return to the scene of their crime? Me and my brothers are waiting here to give him a warm welcome. For Priscilla. Almost did her in, the whore's son.
I know. Here to look for clues and find anyone who might know something.
Fear I can't help you much. But I can tell you what I know.
Priscilla wasn't the sole victim. You aware of that?
Oh, dearie. Of course I was.
This didn't start yesterday. Others have died like this before. Beggars, street girls, orphans. But who'd have a drama concern about them? Human rubbish. It's what the guards call us.
Recall any names?
They didn't have proper ones. Baldy, curly, buns. That's what folk called them. No friends, no families. Their bodies were burned long ago.
You and Priscilla friends?
Friends? Nah. But she saw more than a stupid whore in me. Treated me with respect. It mattered. I was looking to give up whoring, pick up a decent trade. But none would take me. Not as a washerwoman, nor a servant, nor a cook. Felt like a leper, I did. But Priscilla, she was different. Agreed to put me in her play, you see? Lots of the other actors, they were afraid on account of her jesting about the eternal fire. Whistling Wendy on stage, can you imagine it? Well, dream's gone now. I'm back to working street corners.
Sorry to hear that.
You could do worse as work goes. Or so I tell myself.
Take care now. I gotta look around some more. Appreciate it if you didn't disturb me.
Naturally. We'll stand aside, behave. But do tell us if you find anything else here.
Oh, my head's ringing. Got a problem.
Human. Priscilla's. A brazier. This time of year? A brazier. This time of year? I know that smell. Formaldehyde.
So? What is it?
Take care now. I gotta look around some more. Appreciate it if you didn't disturb me.
Naturally. We'll stand aside, behave. But do tell us if you find anything else here.
What do you want?
Man's footprint. The murderer's, maybe. Weighed on his heel. Took a step back.
So, what is it?
Take care now. And I got a murderer to catch.
Surrender on orthodox books. Rivoirs and traps must be in the secret of this mission.
Why not at your waist?
Anyone home?
Be gone, or I'll set me hounds on you. Molly, Strieger, come!
Relax. I'm here about Fabian Meyer, looking for his killer.
That's altogether different. Sit, you stupid mutts, lie down!
Come on. Go on in. Slowly now, lest they bite me.
Charming as beasts go.
You daft? Even I'm scared of them. A better barking dog than an evil man at your door.
Got someone particular in mind?
Sure as shite. Bugger who did Fabian in. Soon as they'd hauled his corpse off, I run to a mate who raises fighting dogs. But these two mutts cost me a chunk of change. But I sleep sound at least.
So who might you be?
The Steph's brother. Gus is the name. We ran a workshop together. Meyer and Meyer.
What'll it be now? Just Meyer?
Name it. I'll be closing it down now. As soon as I find a buyer for this shack, I'll head on to Mahakam. Be near to my family or what's left of it. So, what do you want to know? What can I tell you about Fabian?
Your brother have any enemies? Anyone dislike him? Threaten him, maybe?
T'was Fabian who threatened this one lass. Oh, you were a good dwarf. Craftsman like no other. But you were an incorrigible whoremonger as well. Whenever we put a bit of coin aside, I'd say, let's buy some tools, quality timber. No, he grabbed the purse and head out whoring. Took to following one in particular. He'd say, "'Tis all your fault, dirty bitch, human dishrag." And other obscenities. Don't rightly know what that was about. Maybe he was in love with her.
Know where I can find her, this dishrag?
City cemetery. She died a few days back, quietly in her sleep. Her Ponce the fever took her.
Tell me what you know about the murder, in order, in detail.
T'was like this. Had some work in Oxenfurt, and I was coming home. Saw a plume of smoke rising over the city. Thought to myself, blast it, gonna miss and burn another hag. But the smoke wasn't coming from Hierarch Square. It was coming from here. See the soot stains? That's where they burned our sculptures. Folk gathered round the blaze and found Fabian here beside it. They'd already loaded him on the cart by the time I arrived.
Talk to your neighbors. They see anything suspicious beforehand? Hear anything?
Claimed not to. But even if they had, they'd not have helped. In Novigrad, folk give bleeding orphans in the street a wide berth so as not to stain their poor lanes. Or do they care about some dwarf?
Fine. We've talked enough. Need to look around.
Be my guest. Just beware of the dogs.
Statues of the old gods. Nothing but women. Shapely ones. Murderer dragged something heavy. Dragged something across the floor.
Statues.
Or dragged it from one wall to the other, repeatedly. Bloodstains.
That's where Fabian lay when they found him.
Had a look at your sculptures.
What? Lifelike, aren't they?
Mm-hmm. The women especially. Never seen a bust that size on Melitele.
Oh, aye. Fabian's handiwork. I told him, brother, tits like that would crush her back. Whittle them down. He said, nay, they'd sell better this way. Told me to shut me trap. And sell they did. Till one sermon at the temple. And the celebrating reverend said that whoso buys idols from the non-human Myers sins twofold, as a heretic and as a lecher. That was the end of that.
Mind if I go inside the workshop?
I've not even peeked inside since they found Fabian. But I'll open it for you if you want.
Stains, but not near enough to say he bled to death. Unless somebody got rid of the blood, left a few stains behind. Formaldehyde. Doubt Fabian used it. Furniture got knocked over. This looks like it was kicked. Already know what happened. Fabian was in the workshop. Murderer attacked him there. They struggled. Fabian was overpowered, then tortured for a time.
I needn't know the details. Truth be told, I haven't the stomach for him.
When it was over, the murderer dragged Fabian to the courtyard, then made a pyre of sculptures, set them aflame.
But why? Why do all that?
To teach a lesson. To him, you, the whole city. Fine. We've talked enough. Won't learn anything else here. Take care.
Witcher! Coroner wants to see you. Been another victim. Told me to say the main door will be open for you. You're to come as soon as you can.
Ah!
I'll go, man.
You, Eustace, the corpse collector?
I? How'd you know?
Fourth sense, I think it is. You bring Fabian Meyer's body to the morgue?
Fabian? Oh, yeah, I remember. No ice, no art, one of them, right? No purse neither, as I recall.
One of them? So there have been other bodies like that?
Sure have. Beggars, street urchins, and street walkers. One went so poorly, I had to cut her into pieces to fit her in me wheelbarrow. Slippery Sal, they called her, on account of her.
Some things are best left unsaid. What happened to the pieces?
What do you mean? Reverend Nathaniel ordered them burned. Every last one. Oh, shame that was.
Shame? Why? Actually, never mind. Another thing that's best left unsaid. You search Fabian's body?
Well, I cast an eye in his pockets. Made sure nothing went to waste.
I call a spade a spade. You rob corpses.
And I call a prick. It's none of your fucking concern. What, you tax collector? Piss off, mutant.
Talk. What did you find on him?
I as you wish. Triflings, baubles, gloss beaded wing, handful of coins, and a letter. Look, vellum, quality parchment that. I'll wipe off the writing and sell it as new.
That's human skin. Priscilla, next victim's name. If you'd given this to the right person, she might not have been hurt.
What the fuck do I care what happens to some Priscilla? We sure are wenches in this town. Oi, fucking hell! What was that for?
For everything.
Geralt, right? I'm glad you're here. Held off on the autopsy till you arrived.
Nice of you, especially given you didn't seem pleased about my previous visit.
Because you came unannounced and in unfortunate company. I also had Reverend Nathaniel to contend with. Our spiritual caretaker has left the city on some important matter, and I know who you are, what drives you. I'm more than happy to aid your investigation.
By the way, you and von Gratz don't exactly get along. Why is that?
I had him sent to prison. You see, Joachim led the student protests in 1242, a senseless and brutal revolt. People were dying, Witcher. Those who rejected liberty, equality, and fraternity would be found in the gutter come morning. Their throats slit from ear to ear with surgical precision. Joachim had been my favorite student, but alas, I had to do something. So I reported him. Then I left the university and found work in the morgue, where none care about my past. Whereas Joachim, oh, fate's ironies. Years later, he was appointed head of the very ward I had founded.
How old's von Gratz? 50? 60?
53, I believe. Why do you ask?
You look a little young to have been his teacher.
Not surprising. For years, I've lived in the cold and dark, breathing the vapors of embalming fluids. In short, working with corpses extends one's life. Amusing, is it not?
Who's the victim this time?
Joris Aquinas. A lecturer in theology at Oxenfurt Academy. Found this morning at his home on a catafalque made of his books.
Any titles in particular?
It seems all the tomes dealt with the eternal fire. Treatise critical of the faith's doctrines.
Yeah, mortal sin in Novigrad. Not fond of Nathaniel?
Very few people are. He's cruel and capricious. He stormed in here once, grabbed a scalpel I was sterilizing over a burner, sliced my back with it to the bone, because I had forgotten to lock the storeroom. Hard to be fond of someone like that, wouldn't you agree?
Let's start.
Gladly. The wounds conform to the killer's modus operandi. The victim was bound and forced to drink formaldehyde. Next, the killer removed the eyes, placed burning coals in the sockets, then opened the rib cage and... What's this? A parchment made of human skin.
A message from the murderer, the name of his next victim. Patricia Vagelbud.
Do you know her?
Yes. Even went to her estate once with... Gotta find her, now.
Till next time, Master.
What do you want?
Need to talk to Patricia Vagelbud.
You think any bum off the street can...
Her life's in danger. Let me in or have her blood on your hands.
If you thought this up, and I'll let you in, I'll throw my arse out the door.
Always thought a guard was supposed to protect his charge, not his ass.
So be it. I'll take you to Lady Vagelbud. Just no trickery. Understand?
Oh, Geralt! What a pleasant surprise!
Not pleasant at all. I gotta see your mother. Her life's in danger.
In danger? Come now. I saw Mother this morning. She seemed sad, true, but in perfect health.
Hunting a serial killer, and I've got reason to believe your mother will be his next victim.
Why, even if it's true, our guards...
He's exceptionally cruel when he kills, tortures his victims, cuts out their hearts. So let's see how she is, just in case.
I find this all very hard to believe, but you appear to be quite serious. Please, follow me.
A fire fit for Bellatane. Except it's the wrong time of year.
I mentioned Mother seems sad. Do you remember? In fact, she's in the midst of a crisis of faith. A rather serious one. We'd been to Novigrad. Mother had seen the pyres in Hierarch Square, but had not a word on our way home. She had all the holy books, insignias, reliquaries gathered, taken outside and burnt. Then she locked herself in her room.
We need to hurry.
Killed my son. Now they'll throw us out into the street.
Hear that? Calm and quiet. All seems to be in order.
We should go in, just to be sure.
You're relentless, aren't you? Fine. But wait here, please. Mother's certainly not in the mood for guests.
He ran out the other door! Catch him! Scoundrel!
Spread out! Murderer's still here! There he is! Get him! Put a bolt between your eyes.
Listen, you got the wrong guy.
Save your trickery. Taking you to the heiress.
Well, killer's already escaped. Lead the way, hero.
We got him, Lady Ingrid. Wasn't easy, but...
Lower that crossbow before you hurt yourself. This man is innocent.
Forgive me. I saw him running. Thought it was the killer fleeing.
I was chasing him, and I'd have caught him if you hadn't gotten in my way.
Out of my sight, at once! Mother, why did he do this to her? Why?
Because she blasphemed the eternal fire, only thing that ties her to the other victims. Ingrid, I know this is a hard time for you, but usually the killer leaves a note on the body, a note indicating his next victim. May I?
Very well. But you should be on your own. I do not wish to see her in this state. I do not wish to remember her like that. And let her be the last victim. Please.
Bruises, broken fingernails. She defended herself. Must be why it took him longer, and why he almost got caught. Here it is. Sweet Nettie, crippled Cates. Growing bolder, not just the name, but the place too. Won't get away this time.
Now you.
Sweet Nettie, where is she?
Upstairs. But she's with a very important client. Do not disturb them.
Ooh, we need
it's a material world, and I'm a material girl.
Any needs, Master?
No one will hear you, bitch. Not a soul.
You, though? Whole town will hear you in a minute.
Yet again you disturb me. And I so dislike being disturbed. I was to play with sweet Nettie, render her not so sweet, but I shall see to you first.
What, no foreplay? No formaldehyde? Coals in my eye sockets?
What the fuck are you on about?
Murder. You killed Fabian Meyer, Patricia Vagelbud, and many others.
Bollocks. You're mistaken, vagrant.
Found a message on Patricia's body. Led me here to crippled Kate's, to sweet Nettie. If you didn't leave it, who did?
I don't know, but I see we must talk calmly.
Who knew you'd be here?
Strangely enough, I don't announce these outings far and wide. There's but one man who... That's impossible. He treats even corpses with kid gloves.
The coroner. Said you were busy, that you wouldn't visit the morgue. Gotta go after him.
Go. But to Warehouse 12 at the docks. He's there this time of day, procuring supplies. Formaldehyde. I shall stay here. I've unfinished business with sweet Nettie. After all... I paid in advance.
Then you'll pay again. For her, for all the other women you've tortured. Bad idea. You're free now.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. If not for you. He asked if I did everything, and I said, for the right price, of course. And then he smiled. Oh, God, it gave me the shivers. And then he hit me so hard I passed out. I was bound when I came to, and he was here in the poker, in the fire!
Calm down. He won't hurt you anymore. He won't hurt anyone.
brawny thighs.
What's the hurry, my prince?
As long as they pay and don't hit.
It's a material world, and I'm a material girl.
Don't make me sick.
Run out of formaldehyde. I underestimated you. You almost caught me in flagrante delicto. Now you've seen through my bluff with Nathaniel. Although, you've not divined all, I see. Had you, you would have drawn your silver sword.
Who, what are you?
A vampire. Hire, of course.
Got a reason for killing? A reason to torture?
I thought you'd figure that out as well. The symbolism's rather obvious. Coals for those who are blind to the fire. The egg of a salamander born of fire to replace their cold, doubting hearts. Fire down the throat that...
Yeah, symbolism's clear. What's not is why a vampire would kill in the name of the eternal fire.
Should be equally obvious. I concur with the Church's diagnosis. Novigrad is a fallen city, its population amnesiacs to the very concepts of decency and morality. So I decided to remind them, in a manner they'd be certain to notice.
You're a sick fuck.
I never expected you to understand. You're a cynic and an opportunist. I sensed it from the start. Ah, well, this conversation has grown unpleasant for both parties. We must move to the next item on the agenda. I last fought a Witcher 2 centuries ago. I do hope I remember how it's done. And you? Have you faced one of us? No, you couldn't have. You not have survived.
Yeah.
lollygagging.
One false move and you will regret it.
Please.
If you were an ordinary man, I'd diagnose anemia. But you... you're a witcher.
Yes, Geralt?
Know another surgeon from Oxenford Academy. Her name's Shani. Know her? Red hair, cropped short, freckles.
And a hopeless idealist. Naturally, I know her. She was my assistant for a year.
Any idea where she is now?
My gut tells me she's somewhere along the front, patching up pikemen. I told her it would be futile. In the time she saved 100 lives, another 1,000 would be lost. But medics with a mission, you can't argue with them.
Why is the university in Oxenford closed?
Because it suits Radovid. You've not heard the story? The rector wished to grant him an honorary doctorate. The faculty disagreed. Nonetheless, Radovid arrived for the ceremony, donned a gown, collected his diploma, and when it was over, imprisoned the deans and the entire academic senate so they wouldn't raise a stink. I've been at Vilmerius Hospital ever since, but perhaps it's for the best. I'm far more adept, scalpel in hand, than I ever was behind a lectern.
These murders, got any suspects?
No, Geralt. Though all in all, I should have.
What do you mean?
By virtue of my profession, I know Novigrad's underworld better than most. Dozens of mercenaries, racketeers, bandits, and hired assassins have had their turn on my operating table. Rogues, one and all. But I believe even they could not kill in this manner. So horribly cruel, yet cold, methodical, with absolute precision. Concluding this overlong explanation, I've no notion who's behind it, but I fear them like hell.
Hubert told me about your past, even more vivid than I'd assumed.
I've not time for riddles, Geralt. Be straight or be gone.
Any truth to his claim that people died during the riots at the university? Died for your cause?
I was young and stupid. I thought a better future was worth any price. Even a human life or two. But those are past sins. Sins I've atoned for.
Found and killed the murderer. It was Hubert. You were right not to trust him. He was a higher vampire.
I thought nothing could surprise me in Novigrad. Seems I was wrong. Deeply wrong. Thank you, Geralt. Were it not for you, this would never have ceased.
Farewell. How's...
better, right?
Yes.
Did you take care of what I asked?
Yeah. The Witcher's way.
Thank you, Geralt. For me and Priscilla.
Did my part. Your turn now. Take care of her. Good care.
I will. You'll see. Treat her better than the Dryads of Broccolon could.
She's talking again. Nice surprise.
Isn't it? Professor Von Gratz told me her wounds are healing faster than a troll's. Not the most flattering comparison, but encouraging. Maybe she might even sing again someday. For now, we'll try performing as a duo. She'll play the lute, I'll sing. Dandelion and Calinetta. Got a nice ring to it, doesn't it?
Sounds great. Good luck, Dandelion. On stage and off.
Sorry, Geralt. My throat's still quiet.
Say no more. Get well soon.
Geralt?
Yes, Geralt?
Farewell.